Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. On today's video, we are going to do something that I said that I was not going to do. Tune the car. Follow me and let me explain why I decided to tune it. I know you are going to try to kill me right now because I mentioned a few videos ago that I will not tune my car if I'm still under warranty. That is still the case. Let me explain to you what I mean. But before I do that, first, if you're watching this, probably you are not subscribed. Please make sure that you subscribe to the channel. Hit the notification icon, like the video so that my content can be seen by more people so that they can also enjoy just like you are doing. Before I explain what boot mode is and why I decided to tune the car, let me first explain what exactly I was thinking when I decided to tune the car. If you are familiar with the F80, F82 platform, you would know that there are four different variations of the M model, M3, M4. You have the regular M, that is about 420 horsepower. Then you have the M3 Competition, which is what this car is, or M4 Competition, which is up 440 horsepower. Then you have the M3 M4 CS, that is 463 horsepower. And then you have the M4 GTS, which is 493 horsepower. So all those are the variation of this same engine that I have right here. So what I decided to do is pretty much tune my car going from the M3 Competition to the M4 GTS. So pretty much adding about 50 horsepower to the car. Now, these are still within BMW figures, so I figured that, you know, it won't really kill the engine because, you know, this is something that with the same platform BMW is actually doing. So I decided to do that, and I decided to use the software called boot mode to do it. So let me go ahead now and explain to you what boot mode is, if you don't know. So as I mentioned, boot mode is pretty much a software that pretty much unlock your DME and then allow you to make configuration changes to your, you know, the way your car operates. Now, there are different software that can do that. You have boot mode, you have MHD out there, you have other people like RK Tunes that also do similar things, and you have software that are piggybacks like the JB4 that you actually install on the engine, and actually that one will just kind of trick the engine of thinking that certain things are happening so that the car would act differently. I decided to use boot mode because it is safe and a lot of people are using it with great results. In order for you to use boot mode, you need a few items. You need first, you know, M3, which is the car. You need the Ethernet cable, which is pretty much a cable going from your OBD2 port to an RJ45 that you will connect to your computer. Now, after the computer, laptop, Mac, or cell phone, you will need also a license. Now, I want to point out that if you're using a cell phone, you would need the Wi-Fi agent because the cell phone do not have RJ45 port. So you need something that will, you know, connect and communicate with the DME. That's what you have, that Wi-Fi agent. Now, you also need a license. Now, for the license, there are two ways you can acquire a license. You can either buy a license new directly from boot mode, you know, themselves, so Pro Tuning Freaks. So if you go to them, their website, you can purchase a license for your car for, I believe, about $600. Or you can get a used license from someone who, let's say, sold their car and then transfer the license to you. That's exactly what I did to actually get my license. The inconvenience of doing the transfer license is that you cannot transfer the license. You know, you can only transfer license once, meaning sometimes if you go on a platform, you will see people that are done with their car when they purchase the license from boot mode new. Then when they sell the car, they can transfer the license and, you know, for like a cheaper price. So if you're cheap like me, that's exactly what, you know, you will select. But then once you transfer the license, you install it on your car and then you can tune it. Boot mode, we give you a few different type of maps. You have, for example, what we call the stock map, which is currently what it's installed on your car. That's not what is on the car right now. I already tuned the car. So you also have now the M3 or M4 CS tune. You have the M4 GTS tune. Then you have the M4 CSL tune. I don't know really about the CSL, so I didn't want to use that. So I use the M4 GTS tune. Now you have the stage one, stage two, and then the custom tunes. So all those things are available. And one of the benefits of also doing the transfer license is that first you get the license for cheap. You can get it for free if the person decides to just give it to you though. And then you also get the free map that comes when you purchase the tune. So that's what I decided to do. And a few days ago, it was snowing. I wanted to film this when it was, you know, when I was doing the whole process, but it was snowing. I couldn't really test drive the car. So I just said, you know what, let me play with it. So what I did is I called and a tune, GTS tune and a GTS transmission flash. So I have done those two, but I have not tested. So today you guys are going to see the reaction, how, you know, how it is when I drive it. I will pretty much give my honest review of the GTS tune. Now, the settings that I selected when I tuned the car are pretty simple. I kept the GTS raw, meaning that when the engine starts, it's kind of have that little raw on the back, so it kind of show the muscle of the car. I kept everything stock. I kept the bubble to the GTS bubble. I just set up the sport button to open all the exhaust flaps. And I think I kept everything the same. I didn't really change that much because I wanted it to be as close to GTS as possible. So the only thing I would say that the GTS maybe is different is just the exhaust to be open, fully open when it's on sport or sport plus mode. So enough talking, let me go ahead and warm up the engine and then take the car for a quick test. And I have not even driven this car for a long time, maybe 3 weeks now. So let's go ahead and do this. So I have the car in sport mode, everything is in sport. Traction control is on, and let me see what this car is about now in this GTS. Oh my goodness. Oh Lord, this is fun. Woo! Yes, this is it, this is good. It's definitely different. Wow, that's definitely different than the way the car was before. That I can tell you, it is different. Not too different, but it is kicking. I can't wait to try Sport Plus. So sport mode, I launched about half on the throttle, and the response was immediate. It was pretty brutal, but let me put now in sport plus, and let's see. All right, so I have it on sport plus for engine, suspension, and steering wheel. I have the DSC still on. Let me make a quick U-turn here. Yeah, definitely Sport Plus, it is very, very brutal. This is just GTS, it's not even stage one. And I don't hear too much bubble. I mean, the bubbles are there, but they are not really aggressive because I kept it with the GTS. So it's pretty well. I hope you can hear it on camera. And they are loud. Exhaust is pretty loud. And the transmission is also really, like, you can feel like it feels like the transmission has more power, and that's exactly what a lot of people describe with this, you know, once they tune with this GTS transmission flash. It feels like the transmission has more power because you can feel it gripping more on the gears. actually, you know what, let me drive a little bit in just regular mode, efficient, just to see if there's any difference in that mode. So far I love it, man. So far I love the tune. In efficient mode, I don't feel any difference between the way the car was before and now. So efficient mode is definitely the same, no change. Let me see if I can launch it. Yeah, do a launch control really quick. Definitely not ready for this. If I didn't let go of the throttle, I would still be doing burnouts over there on these winter tires. All right guys, I hope you guys had fun watching me, you know, trying this GTS boot mode tune. I had a great time, and man, I have to say that the car is definitely handling differently. You know, on sport mode, it's very aggressive, but not compared to Sport Plus. Sport Plus is definitely a beast. I believe that Sport Plus really is meant for the track, and hopefully this summer I will have the chance to take the car to the track. So if you haven't subscribed, make sure that you do, and also follow me on my Instagram at Torvec Motors. On this note, I will let you go and see you on the next video. Say bye to the car.